I'm gonna give you the Throws University glide progressions, and we're gonna start right now. What's up, everybody? It's Dane Miller from throwsuniversity.com. And if this is your first time to the channel and you're interested in becoming a better shot putter, you want to learn more about the discus, or maybe you're a coach and you want to improve your throws-based knowledge, make sure that you like, you subscribe, and you ring that notification bell so we can help you become a champion. So we get asked this question all the time. How have you been able to progress a glider like Lucas Warning to be able to add 15 feet to his standing throw? What are the glide progressions that you've taken to get his glide from 46 feet in high school to 65 feet as a post-collegiate glider? And a lot of that has to do with how we've developed him over time. We've had him since he was 17 years old, and how we've gone about improving his technique by utilizing each glide drill. And the big key factor is that we've got to start off with teaching the standing throw properly as a glider. We've got to have our gliders take a nice, wider base standing throw. We teach the short, long glide. We don't teach the long, short glide. We prefer the short, long glide. So if we know that that is what we're working towards as coaches, the standing throw has to be based around that longer standing throw position. So the standing throw, when you're teaching it, has to be focused on opening that non-dominant arm or that left arm. It has to be focused on holding that grounded position and then finishing forward. That second key progression is gonna get us to the A drill. The A drill is going to help us teach our gliders how to be dynamic out of the back. We wanna have a nice dynamic start because we're teaching the short, long glide. They're gonna have to be patient with their hips dropping out of the back and their hips coming across the circle. The big key factors in the A drill, we want that left arm and the shoulders to stay square. We want them to stay level. We want them to stay facing the back of the circle. We want that left leg to be very close to the concrete. And then finally, when they get to that A drill position, we want to be aggressive from the right quad, from the right heel. We want our gliders to know they have to come off of that heel. And that leads us into our third key glide drill. And that's gonna be actually the step back drill. So one of the things that I really like about the step back drill is that it puts that right foot in the middle. And the right foot in that short, long glide, we want to stay plantar flexed. We want that knee to stay flexed. And that's what you're gonna get out of the step back drill. The right foot will be where it needs to be. It's gotta be where it should be grounding from a full throw. It's gotta be where it should be when you're taking your standing throws. So that step back, that right foot should be in the middle, the ankle should be flexed, the knee should be flexed, the right hip should be flexed. And then as you step back aggressively and that left leg goes to the front, we want to see that left arm open up and that right shoulder go forward. And that's going to take us to our fourth key drill. That fourth key drill is what we refer to as the lathe drill. So this is named after NCAA champion Lathe Arrhenius, who threw close to 20 meters with the glide. And what we like to do here is it's basically like taking the A drill. You get to that nice A position, but that next step, we hold that A position, we get our right foot to come to the middle aggressively, we hold that right ankle plantar flex, we hold that right knee flex, we hold the right hip flex, and then we're gonna have our left arm open up and we're gonna finish in a long grounded push out into the sector. And that lathe drill is gonna get us to that fifth key aspect. Now we're able to take this and start to transfer to a non-reverse. So we wanna see with the non-reverse, we wanna see us drop dynamically out of the back. Remember, those are the key facets of the A drill. That's a key factor when we're talking about that lathe drill. We wanna see those hips drop. We wanna see a nice strong drive off of that right heel out of the back. Now, when we ground in the middle with the non-reverse, we want our right ankle to be plantar flexed. We want our right knee to be flexed. That's where we want that step back drill position to come into play. Then when that left leg grounds at the front, now we're at our standing throw and we want to finish in a long grounded standing throw at the front when we're doing the non-reverse. So it's important that we know when we educate our gliders and our shot putters on how each drill factors and builds upon the previous drill. And then ultimately after those nons, now we're at our full throw. We can go full throttle. We've got a good understanding of how to get out of the back of the circle. We have a really good understanding of the positions we have to hold in the middle of the circle. And we have a very firm understanding of how we have to finish grounded into a nice big reverse where our right heel holds on the toe board and we hit monster PRs. So if you want more information about gliding, about throwing, about becoming a better thrower, you can head over to throwsuniversity.com and pick up our 30 days to a better glider program. That's 30 days of coaching and programming designed specifically by us here at Throws University to help you become a better glider. If you want more videos about gliding and about shot putting in general, you can click on this video right here. Until next time, guys, peace.